Jim Jarmusch's 1989 cinematic marvel Mystery Train is a gem. Not only is it brilliant in a subtle, patient Jim Jarmusch way, but it inspired Quentin Tarantino, who at the time of Mystery Train's release would have been 25 or 26 years old, when he would go on to write True Romance and Reservoir Dogs. Let's dive deeper. Mystery Train on the surface is presented like an episodic film with actual chapter titles. Three chapters, three stories. This is something Tarantino would be famous for, taking a literary approach to cinema, starting with Reservoir Dogs. But in both films, especially in Mystery Train, the stories or events are all connected. Jim Jarmusch does this with three devices. The first is location, which is a hotel called the Arcade Hotel. Roger Ebert in his review described the hotel as being on life support. In Reservoir Dogs, it's the warehouse that connects the non-linear storytelling because it's where all the gangsters know to go after the heist.
You ever listen to Kay Billy's Super Sounds of the 70s?
Then we have the music. Now, of course, we know the movie soundtrack and Tarantino are synonymous. His DJ Kay Billy character that's on the radio station is prominent all throughout Reservoir Dogs. The radio station and thus the music is the soundtrack to this gangster's day and even lives. In Mystery Train, the three stories are connected by the Blue Moon song, and the radio DJ is Tom Waits.
With one of my personal early morning favorites, Blue Moon.
That's Mel, our engineer. Just coffee, huh? I love you. Well, yes, sir, that's another classic from Mr. Roy Orbison, along with the Roses, previously known as the Teen Kings for you trivia fans, with Domino here. You're on the air until dawn. It's 2:17 right here in Memphis, Tennessee. Right now, here's another one recorded at Sun Studios, this time by the King himself. That's right, Mr. Elvis Presley, with one of my personal early morning favorites, Blue Moon.
The song shows us exactly when and where and what the characters in each story were doing. It's subtle, dramatic suspense and soon tension that's brought on by the third device, the gunshot.
You need some money.
I'm supposed to give you money.
Take it.
200? No.
Take it.
What was that, a gunshot?
Maybe a 38.
Jesus!
What about the gunshot in Reservoir Dogs, you might ask? Is there one just as important? Now, there are guns all throughout the movie, but there's one in particular that is crucial to the story, one in which an informant hiding in plain sight didn't count on. Now, I could be reaching. I could be wrong. This could all be really just a strange, huge, amusing coincidence, like the fact Steve Buscemi is in both films. Or the fact there's a ghost Elvis in Mystery Train and in True Romance.
As long as you're not at the scene of the crime, smoking gun in your hand.
or an instance of artists and great minds thinking alike. At any rate, Mystery Train is an 80s gem and deserves much more praise and a rediscovery, if not more credit for the development and cinematic path Tarantino would trail and set ablaze in the 90s.